opportunities for us to meet and to just let down our guard a little bit, for you to come and to do your work in us and to speak to us and for us to have a quiet place to hear you. And so, Lord, I just pray that we would be able to really press in for what you have for us and not lose our awe and wonder of who you are. Lord, you're so much bigger than all the stuff we bring into this room with us tonight. And we can easily forget that when our stuff feels big. I pray for your grandness to enter into this room this evening. Father, I pray that you would strip away all the things that get in the way of us hearing you, seeing you, experiencing you, remembering your truths, speaking your word to us. to wait on an everlasting promise that we have. And the next couple songs just sort of take us to that foot of the cross to ask the Lord to help us to lay down what's ours and to pick up what He has for us.
Streams.
grace that you extend to us. Every time that we are willing to come before you and surrender, you are there with forgiveness and mercy and grace. I pray that it is to you that we look for our help. That it is to you that we bring the troubles of our heart. May we pray about it as much as we talk about it. I lift my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
Faithful one, so unchanging.
read scripture, it's the same God. It's the same God that covered forever, that has carried his people through forever. And we get to step into that. And that feels like such an incredible privilege. And I'm just thankful to him tonight for how faithful he is. Defender, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the Almighty God. I pray, Lord, that our spirit would be still in front of you this evening. That when we don't know what else to do, it's enough. Be still, to worship, to wait on what you have for us.
All I did was
covering, that we can be kept in the shadow of your wing. And just as we want to keep our kids safe and we want to do our best for them, Lord, you love us that much and more. That's amazing grace. I thank you for that covering. I thank you for that protection. That you have been leading us, that you still continue to lead us. Father, we proclaim the victory that you have. And it's hard to see in the world right now, but we proclaim that you have victory over the world, that you have victory over death, that you have victory over sin, that it's ours to hand over to you. So that I pray that nothing would come in our way of that, that we wouldn't hang on to our own sin, to our own stuff. I thank you that you sent your Son, that you made a way for us to know you and to meet with you. And I thank you that you sent Holy Spirit.
Destined to die, Lord, I've
heart here. Don't be nervous. I want you to speak out what God has been for you. Just a word. You don't have to give a whole story, but how has God been showing up for you? So we've sang a few songs, how he is our anchor, our hope, our defender. How is God showing up for you? Is there a word that you can speak out in testimony of who God is for you? Sometimes words are powerful. We can do all our prayer in our head and quietly, and it's powerful, and we have moments with the Lord, but we need to hear each other. We need to hear our testimony of who God has been to us, because there'll be moments where he will be Paul's sustainer, and I will remember that he's my sustainer too, that he's answered Leslie's prayers, and he will answer our prayers. So I know sometimes it feels weird to speak it out, but it's important. It's important for each other and even for our own faith journey to just speak out who God is to us. You might feel crazy. We get up in the morning and speak it out loud. God, you're the Lord over this day. I will submit to you. God gives us a scripture in Zephaniah that says, "The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. He will exalt over you with loud singing." It's a beautiful verse, and we take it as this really precious moment, but read the chapter. There's just a lot going on. It's not a real super peaceful time. And I actually love these ones. I love these ones that we hear used so often, and then you read it in context, and you're like, wow, Lord, is that a promise? Is that ever a beautiful thing to say to your people in the midst of chaos? So know that the Lord is singing over you. Know that the Lord is loving you. Know that the Lord is correcting you where you need it. We need all of those things for him to come. This next song is Raise a Hallelujah, and it's basically an anthem to say whatever's happening, I will worship. I will proclaim your name no matter what life looks like around me.
Thank you.
yourself plain to us, but not to the world. Because a loveless world, said Jesus, is a sightless world. If anyone loves me, he will carefully keep my word, and my Father will love him. We'll move right into the neighborhood. Not loving means not keeping my words. The message you are hearing isn't mine. It's the message of the Father who sent me. I'm telling you these things while I'm still living with you. The friend, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send at my request, will make everything plain to you. He will remind you of all these things I have told you. I'm leaving you well and whole. That's my parting gift to you, peace. I don't leave you the way you're used to being left, feeling abandoned, bereft. So don't be upset. Don't be distraught. You've heard me tell you, I'm going away and I'm coming back. If you loved me, you would be glad that I'm on my way to the Father. Because the Father is the goal and purpose of my life. What a hope. I love the statement where it says, I'm not leaving you the way you're used to being left. We have this living hope that yes, he's gone, but yes, he's coming back. And he's left us Holy Spirit who will remind us of who he is and what he has said. I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing our last song together tonight, Living Hope.
Lay between us.
us. I pray your blessing over your people as they go this week, that they will have moment after moment of being reminded of who you are, that you will just show up in so many ways, and that we will have eyes to see, that we will have ears to hear. Thank you, Father, for meeting with us. In your name we pray.